Welcome to GLOBALink, brought to you by Xinhua News Agency. I'm Yang Yunqi in Beijing. Since the outbreak of the COVID-19 epidemic, the world has been looking forward to vaccines, a key to stop the spread of the deadly virus. China has been racing against time to focus on the research and development work of COVID-19 vaccine. What are the different principles and efficacy of different kinds of vaccines? Find out the answers in today's GLOBALink.
At present, several vaccines have been approved for use, including emergency authorization. Vaccines produced by different manufacturers are slightly different in terms of production methods, effectiveness, storage and transport conditions, prices, and so on. The Pfizer's and Moderna's vaccines are mRNA-based. China's Sinopharm and Sinovac vaccines are both inactivated vaccines. And the Sputnik V and Oxford AstraZeneca vaccines are adenovirus vector vaccines. The transport and storage requirements for mRNA vaccines are much higher than other kinds of vaccines.
从目前正式上市使用的这个疫苗来看，新冠灭活疫苗的这个工艺是比较成熟，对于生产过程的生物安全的要求呢比较高。它的储运温度一般为2到8度，那么新冠的mRNA疫苗。
从理论上来讲，它具有这个研发周期短、生产条件易于控制等等优点。但是因为它呢，毕竟是第一款用这个技术开发的这个第一次上市的疫苗，所以说还需要一段时间来完善它的工艺。目前呢，它的这个储藏的温度是要求低温啊，甚至是-70度的这个极低的温度来进行储运。
其实要从三个层面上去判断。 这个疫苗的有效或者是这个疫苗的效果，第一个方面是安全有效，第二个指标就是可及性指标，就是你容易获得这个疫苗，你获得这疫苗之后使用起来、运输起来方便。第三个层次呢，就是要可负担，简单的说就是成本。那么成本的基础是什么呢？是产量。那么我们这三个条件、三个标准都达到了，
不良反应肯定是有。 但是它那个大部分还是，局部的一个疼痛和轻度的发热，就是远远低于我们这个各类已经上市的疫苗的总的副反应的发生。
我们中国的格局叫有苗低病，这个格局下。 我们优先使用的原则是什么呢？一定是谁最容易得病、被感染、去传播。那么这些人员主要就是18岁到60岁的工作年龄段，还有一部分是又有苗又有病的国家，它因为发病率非常高，它重点保护人群就从发病的风险转向了发病之后带来的隐患，就是带来的危害程度，就是老年人。 所以其实是因为全球的新冠疫情流行格局是不一样的，所以选择疫苗使用的人群也是不一样的。When
enough people are protected by vaccines, a barrier to stop the spread of the virus is formed, so as to achieve herd immunity against COVID-19. What is the relationship between herd immunity and vaccination?
影响疫苗接种形成的人群免疫力的因素有很多。 包括疫苗它的本质的效力和产品的质量，个体和群体对疫苗的易感性，接种人群的覆盖率，接种的时效，以及病毒会不会发生重大变异，人群暴露于这个感染源的这个机会啊几率，和免疫后获得的保护力，以及啊还要受人群的一些特征的影响，比如说年龄分布啊等等。那么疫苗的这个有效率啊。 我理解呢是一个综合指标体系，是多因素统计分析的结果，所以说我们不能片面地过度地追求其中某一个单一的指标。Why
has the same vaccine delivered vastly different efficacy rates?
这个各国在病例诊断的标准、实验流程的设计等方面呢是存在着差异的，不同的现场、不同的人群、不同的疾病流行背景、不同的分组方式。 乃至采用了不同的统计分析的方法，那么都可能会造成同一款疫苗 在不同的地方，它的这个显示出来的有效率的这个统计结果啊不完全一致。
我们在巴西研究的结果是总共10000多名志愿者，那么竟然录入了250个病例，这250个病例里边85%都是极轻症，它是核酸阳性，但是它不用去就医的。那恰恰就是这部分人的保护率低。为什么这部分人保护率低呢？因为我做的全是医护人员，医护人员他每天到医院上班，那他被病毒攻击的次数是3次、5次，甚至更多，他保护率就应该低。所以说，我们是在全世界唯一一个，也是第一个做了医护人员的保护效果。为什么要做医护人员保护？因为疫情高度流行状态下，现在最大的风险是医疗体系崩溃，我们必须把医护人员当成我们流行的重点保护对象，所以我们大胆的冒着风险的选择了医护人员。我们的灭活疫苗是全病毒疫苗，它的抗原构成是最复杂的，那么我们认为它应该应对新冠病毒的不同地区的毒株、不同的变异株更有广谱性。
那么前面我们也获得过大概有7、8个株吧，能够病毒株啊变异的，我们这个疫苗免疫以后都能保护。那么从英国这次变异的这个毒株来看，我们认为也可以保护，应该是可以覆盖的。这个实验我们正在做。
As the COVID-19 pandemic continues, vaccines are regarded as powerful weapons to fight it.A growing number of countries and regions have approved the use or emergency use of Chinese vaccines. Many have reached a procurement agreement with China. Chinese vaccines will inject confidence into these countries and regions in their fight against the pandemic.
É uma boa vacina que tem a sua eficácia dentro dos limites do aceitável pela comunidade científica, pela Organização Mundial de Saúde, por parâmetros internacionais.
Some of the more mature technologies like inactivated vaccines, which for the moment we see the Chinese vaccines are utilizing, it's something of a much more reassuring and more mature technology.
Artık aşının Türk insanında etkili ve güvenilir olduğundan eminiz.
China é um país, né, que é uma potência na produção de insumos.Tem se tornado cada vez mais importante na produção de ciência e tecnologia, né, um dos países líderes na produção, na pesquisa para a produção da vacina contra a Covid.
We can see the willingness of the government of China to provide and part of the global initiative to tackle this pandemic.
Chinese vaccines have been recognized by many countries for their safety, efficacy, fair price, easy storage and transport, wider range of use, and most importantly, high capacity. From promising to make its vaccine a global public good, to joining the COVAX facility backed by the World Health Organization, China has been active in promoting global vaccine cooperation.